Okay, now, before we start with our second topic for consumer behavior, as per what I mentioned last week, okay, we're going to do the case study one. Okay, case study one, can you open your VLE and open chapter one case study, hey Alexa, what is consumer behavior? Case, open your VLE first, look at the case study for chapter one. Okay, everyone ready with the chapter one for case study?
Wait, sir, still loading the page.
Loading, all right. How about the rest? How about the rest? You guys okay? Nur Atira. Nur Atira, where are you?
Yes, you.
Switch on your camera.
I belum pakai tudung, jap.
Pakai tudung cepat. Nur Atira. Can you explain to me what is this case study is all about? Nur Atira.
Yes.
Can you give me the summary of this case study?
Of what?
Can you give me the summary of this case study? Case study is your VLE, case study one, case study for chapter one.
I belum tengok macam.
Is it how Alexa can identify consumer behavior through the consumer? When people subscribing Alexa, they try to order Alexa to order stuff and buying stuff from the e-commerce platform, and also what kind of songs that they prefer to play to the Alexa play to. That also.
Okay. this is that is the issue. But first thing first, before we jump into the gun, okay, jump into the issue. I would like you to understand the case study first, okay? Because this is an exercise for your exam, your final assessment, okay? Because for last semester, I from my observation, okay, I learned that the comprehension of the case study is something which that we need to remedy. Means most of students do not understand the case study, so they can't answer the question. So what I'm doing for this semester, for each topic, there will be a case study. Okay, we're going to discuss the case study, not only the answer, but before we go to the answer, I would love to discuss on your understanding of the case study first. Then only we go to the question. Okay, so we go step by step. First is your understanding about the case study. All right. Amelia Sofia. Amelia Sofia, where are you? Switch on your camera. Can you guys switch on your camera? All of you need to switch on your camera. Not after I ask or I mention your name. Right now, you need to switch on your camera. Where is Amelia Sofia?
Sir, can I ask you something? I know this is one of Alyssa, but do you believe about an apparel clothing that can repel 99% of COVID-19 virus?
What can repel COVID-19?
Apparel, the cloth.
The what? I didn't get what you say. This one is
break clothing, down. Clothing. Clothing.
The
apparel.
COVID.
I just found it yesterday, and I don't know, it was legitimately legit, or I don't know, it's kind of funny actually to me, but I don't know if it's proven to be legit or not.
But, okay, this is I think the vaccine, whatever vaccine, I think of course they're developing the vaccine right now. So until they clinically proven, the jury is still out there, right? We're still waiting for the vaccine to come. But prior to the vaccine, we all need to take precaution, okay? To stay vigilant, make sure that you're safe, okay? Maintain the SOP and all that. I'm quite worried. Okay, I'm quite worried. Because when I look to the social media, when I look at the Instagram, for example, my student, my former student, I can see that there's lacking of social distancing. There's a lot of physical contacts and all that. I'm quite worried. I got worried on that. So before we find the cure, just stay vigilant, okay? Stay safe, all that. Right. Now, question. Okay. I'm asking who's just now? Is it Amelia Sophia?
Alexander.
Where is Amelia Sophia?
Kat sini sekejap eh. Saya pakai tudung sekejap.
Oh yeah, okay. Cepatlah pakai tudung. Okay, for those who are with tudung or hijab, know when you attend the class, alright, I'm going to ask you to switch on the camera. No? Before 12 tu, pakailah tudung. Talking about COVID-19, I'm going to talk about, you know, when we talk about behavior after this, and there's something that has something to do with COVID-19. Okay, but then, first thing first, we're going to talk about the case study. So, where is Amelia Sophia? Cepat, Amelia Sophia. Right, Muhammad Johan Alif. Muhammad Johan, where are you?
Yes.
Turn on your camera, Muhammad Johan.
Okay.
Muhammad Johan. Muhammad Johan Ali, can you switch on your camera and give me the summary of this case study?
Can you see me?
Right. I can't see you. Okay, Muhammad Johan. Tell me the summary of this case study. What is this case study is all about? Mohd Johan, I think you are on mute. I can't hear you. Johan, I can't hear you. You need to switch on your speaker. You're on mute.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. Yeah, you're back. You're back now. Tell me the summary of this case study.
The summary of this case study. Yes. This case study actually is about Alexa, which is the Amazon's Echo in the market, which is in market speakers, smart speakers. Alexa actually is a digital assistant for a person. To open up the music or ask about the weather.
Okay. What's so special about this Alexa?
It is helpful for someone that need to know something so quickly. And then what else? Maybe try to ask some recipe. You can ask about Alexa to set your alarm and something else.
All right. No Farida Hanin.
No Farida. Yes,
sir. Where are you, No Farida Hanin?
Ada ni. Ada.
Okay. Saya nampak. Saya nampak kepala awak dia.
Nampak tak?
Alright, nice. I see you. Now, No Farida Hanim. In this case study, it says something about although Alexa is an AI, artificial intelligence, right? But can you comment on the personal touch that this Alexa have with human? With the owner of this Alexa.
Maksud se macam mana tadi? Kurang jelas lah.
Maksudnya macam Alexa ni dia artificial intelligence.
Okay.
Kan? So macam mana dia berinteraksi? Apa connection dia daripada level emotional atau dari segi emotion dengan manusia?
Oh, kejap. Dia maybe dia jap sebab macam kita tahu AI tu dia kan based on macam dia ni kan something sama yang macam kejap apa mana tadi yang baca dia kan macam something yang macam Google, macam Hey Google apa tu semua kan, so kan. So, macam apa yang saya tahulah dekat based on sini, mungkin based on suara ke se? Maksudnya, macam tak faham sangat lah.
Suara? Okay, now. This, tak faham sangat. Apa yang awak tak faham?
Okay, based on macam dia punya, apa nama, case study ni, saya macam dapat tahulah yang apa Alexa ni one of macam some things yang macam nak tahu kita punya behavior. Macam contohlah macam Facebook kan. Saya apa yang saya faham lah. Contoh macam Facebook, kalau macam apa-apa ke kita search ke apa semua, tiba-tiba nanti sponsor dia pop up dekat kita punya feed tu. So macam apa yang saya tahu macam Alexa ni dia nak tahu kita punya behavior based on kita punya search ke macam tu. Sebab dia cakap kat sini this category include tools such as Apple Siri. So maksudnya macam macam mana nak cakap apa yang kita nak search ke based on kita cakap hey Siri, can you search me for maps? Macam tu lah apa yang saya faham lah. So
okay. Okay, memang, okay. Yes, Alexa is the same class of product like Siri, what else? Macam for example,
Google,
for example. Yes, but somehow, okay, according to this case study, the owner of this Alexa become, how to say, emotionally attached. They become so-called friends. Okay, I know for a fact some of my friends who are single, okay, even ask Siri, because you know that you can ask Siri anything, right? And she asked Siri, why nobody love me, something like that. Alright, then to that extent, okay, they become friends, okay, as if like Siri or Alexa, for example, in this case, you become emotionally attached. There's some emotional link between you and Alexa, between you and Siri. Alright, why? Because perhaps someone is lonely. He need to talk to someone, right? And they started to talk to Siri, so they become like friends. Okay, they become like friends. So basically, this is what the case study is talking all about. Because first, Alexa is used to search. Okay, to search something. For example, like in Google, you need to stroke the keyboard, right? You need to use the keyboard to ask or to search for something. But using Alexa or you use Siri, you can just ask voice control and Alexa or Siri will tell you what is the answer. Okay, but because of this Alexa or Siri, they are some sort like mimicking human voice, mimicking human intonation. So over the time, we become attached to Siri, we attach to Alexa, as if like we are friends. Then because you talk to your friends all the time, but since you do not have friends, you are lonely, you talk to Siri or you talk to Alexa for information. All right, so this is what the core or the crux of this article is all about. Now, Muhammad Azim Aiman. Where are you, Muhammad Azim Aiman?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, switch on your camera. Okay, Muhammad Azim. Let's go to question number one. Okay? Choose two of your favorite brands and devise an idea for Alexa skill that consumers would find useful. Question number one. Alright. Choose two of your favorite brands and devise an idea for Alexa skill that consumers would find useful. Okay.
Tak faham masa dia macam mana masa.
Alright, now okay, let me stop you right there. Can I just make a quick survey? Okay. Can I make a quick survey? How many of you, okay, despite my notice last week, okay, last week, at the end of the last week, end of class last week, I told in the class, okay, at the end of the class, I told all of you that next week we're going to discuss case study number one before I start topic number two. So just a quick survey, how many of you actually read this case study before coming to this class? None. All right. So get out from the case study. Go back to your VLE and look at the second topic.
Baca, sir. Tapi dia, saya tak faham sangat.
Yes.
Kurang faham, sir.
Yes. Open your VLE, go to the topic number two. Okay, topic number two, learning and memory. We look under week two, consumer product knowledge and involvement. There are three things there, Coca-Cola marketing strategy, CB case study two, and then downstairs you got learning and memory. You click on that, learning and memory. It goes to the slide for the second topic. Semua dah dapat?
Dah, sir.
Alright. Okay. Now, learning and memory. Okay, if you look at the second slide, is conditional results in learning. Okay, now, you may want to ask, Sharin, why should we learn about memories? Why should we learn about learning? Okay, what is that got to do with marketing? Right now, for today's topic, okay, when we learn about how people learn, how people memorize something or memorize an information, it has some relevancy with how people process the information of your advertisement. Okay, meaning to say, when we advertise, okay, when we learn about advertising, when we advertise to the consumer, okay, we need consumer to learn about our product, learn about our service, and then about our ideas, and store that in the memory. Why is that important for a consumer to memorize about our brand? Why?
Sebab nanti easy for us to be well known ke?
Okay, meaning the moment that people can memorize our product, people can recognize our brand. Yes, you are right that it's easy for people to recognize our product. So what's so important, why people should recognize our product? Why? What's the impact when people recognize our brand?
Leads to loyalty.
They will purchase
our product.
Yeah.
Loyalty.
People will stick
to our brand. Brand. So, your brand will be preferred from another brand, right? a well-known brand will be preferred compared to brand which is not known to you. Okay, meaning to say, let's say you see Coke and brand B, for example. Of course, you're going to choose Coke. Why? Because it's something that you recognize Coke. You do not recognize brand X or B, for example. So easy for the marketers to market their product because it's already recognizable. Something which you can recognize, something which is familiar to you. Okay, for example, let's say you wanted to go for dinner, for example. You wanted to go out for dinner. You don't have much time. Are you going to the place which is familiar to you, or you going to try something new? Of course, you go to somewhere which is
based
familiar.
On situation, sir.
Situation, kenapa? Why? Why? What situation?
If let's say lah, tempat tu baru lagi and tiba-tiba dia viral, mestilah kita pun akan nak try pergi sana. So kita pun akan nak try diorang punya produk. So macam orang lain kata sedap-sedap macam, so kita pun nak try lah. So bandingkan dengan kedai yang kita dah selalu pergi, so kita try another new lah, macam tu.
Correct. Okay. You're right in the way that the viral, the word viral here is an intervention which we going to learn next week. Okay, intervention in decision making. But you also see something which is somewhere that you always go. Right, meaning to say, if something like you're just going for a normal dinner, routine dinner, you will go somewhere which you always go. Meaning something which is similar, familiar to you, right? Right, so that is the, so out of 10 dinner, 9 will go to somewhere you are familiar, 1 you go to the place which is viral. Correct. So the familiarity here is what stored in your memory. Okay, that's why learning and memory, and how we know how people learn about something, and we know how people store their memory about something, is important to us as a marketer. Alright. So then let's look at the second slide. It talks about conditional results in learning. Okay, conditional results in learning. Okay, first slide. Learning is relatively permanent change in behavior caused by experiences. Now, okay, I purposely put first behavior, then across I put experience. Why? Because you learn by experience. Okay, you learn by mistake. You learn by doing something. Okay, when you do something, you do a mistake, or you experience something, then that's how you learn. Okay, that's how you learn. So this is how, okay, this one way of you learning. Okay, this is how some possible learn about certain thing by experience. Okay, right now is you are learning by, for example, you are learning by listening to the online videos, for example, online class. But you also can learn by doing it, meaning to say, instead of learning from this, okay, from this online class, you go and practice this, okay, outside. You try to sell something outside. And then the experience, okay, that you get from doing something, you learn from it. Okay, you learn from it. For example, like if last semester you learn in certain ways, meaning you, let's say you do, you study last minute, you send assignment last minute, then let's say you got B or you got C, for example. Right, so something tells you that you need to learn from that experience. So you cannot, when you go to the next semester, you cannot learn or you cannot study in the same way. Why? Because if you study the same way, you repeat the same mistake, all right, what you did last semester, then you will get the same result. Okay, insanity is something which is doing something which is the same thing over and over again and expecting the different result. So if you not, if you want a different result, okay, you need to do something differently. Okay, meaning why do you do something differently? Because you have learned your mistake. Alright, so that's how you learn. Sometimes some people ask me, okay, some student ask me, can you give me one piece of advice? Okay, my advice would be to any of my students would be go out, make a lot of mistakes, try something new, and when you try something new, you're going to do a lot of mistakes, but learn from that mistake. Okay, but don't repeat the same mistake, and that is insanity, and that's stupidity. You're only going to be more refined as you grow older. When you do a lot of things, you try a lot of things, you're bound to make mistakes, but you will learn, you'll become a better person. All right, so learning is relatively permanent change in behavior caused by experience. So you guys, like now, how old are you? 21, 22?
23.
So you've been living in this world for 23 years. All right? So what shape your behavior, okay, what shape your behavior as at this moment is what we have experienced for the past 23 years in this world. Okay, every minute, every second, every hour that you've been in this world, that is your experience. And that experience shape your behavior now. Okay, so this is what you learn. Okay, you learn from your experience. Okay, if you go to the next slide, it says that events that we experience when we are young often exert a lasting influence on our preferences as we get older. Okay, this is a statement. Okay, this is proven by research. But the most important thing is, how does this present an opportunity to marketers like you? Okay, is this any marketing opportunity when we know that event that we experience when we are young often exert a lasting influence on our preferences as we get older? What is the marketing opportunity here? Siti no Shakira.
We target young audience.
Young audience. Why? How do we target the young audience?
When we selling something, young people will like to buy.
Like last week when we talk about Milo, okay, Milo, okay, one of you talking about Milo, then, why he said Milo? Because he choose Milo because he remembered that when he was young, he drinks Milo from the truck. Okay. during sports day, for example. It brings out the memory. So that's how you target the young. But young here, not only children. You guys also young. That's why you see that marketers right now, whenever we talk about marketing, they go for millennials. They're talking about the Gen Y. They're talking about the Gen X. Okay, the millennials. Why? Because you are young. So they try to influence your behavior or your preference right now, because when you enter into the job market, when you have the disposable income, then you already have that brand preference. You already preferred certain brand. So when you go to the job market, you have the disposable income, then you can buy those brands. So meaning to say, like, they are investing in the future. Why? Because you guys are the future, right? So they always targeting young people, young market, like you guys. Okay. Now, next slide. Behavioral learning theories. Okay, now this is the theory. What is the name of theory? Behavioral learning. So under this theory, it assumes that learning takes place as a result to external event. Meaning, if you look at the next slide, this theory assume that our mind is like a black box. It's like nothing, empty. But our learning is based on the external or external stimuli. All right, then from the external stimuli, it goes to our mind, which is the black box, and it will engender or will create our response to that stimuli. So this is what behavior learning theories is all about. Okay, this theory assumes that our mind is a black box. Then our mind is our response are based on the stimuli, the external stimuli that goes into our mind. All right, then it create a response. So now, what are stimuli? You know, the external stimuli can be what we have learned, what we have experienced, what is being shown to you. Okay, meaning, for example, like right now. Okay, let's talk about COVID-19, for example. Right now, during the pandemic, is the best time to look at the human behavior. Okay, last time is quite difficult to gauge the human behavior from the media, but with the social media, it's quite easy for us to look at the behavior of human when they respond to the pandemic. If you look at the Twitter right now or the Facebook right now, what is your observation of the human behavior in response to the pandemic, in response to the COVID-19? What is your observation when you browse through your social media?
Verified with the current situation.
Yeah, with regard to the current situation in Malaysia.
Horrifying, sir.
Very what?
Horrifying.
Nur Idina, what's your opinion? The behavior, human behavior, from your observation in the social media. Nur Idina?
Yes, sir.
Nur Idina, from your observation, you ada social media, kan?
Ada.
Ada. ada, when you browse through your social media, awak nampak tak apa-apa response ataupun awak observe tak kelakuan ataupun ialah kelakuanlah behavior yang awak nampak dalam social media berkaitan dengan COVID-19 ni di Malaysia sekarang?
Contoh kan bila kes meningkat, ada certain people mungkin macam salahkan orang lain, macam kan disebabkan apa pilihan raya tu kan. Mungkin.
Alright. No, that's a good point, Nur Idina. You can see you see that people are angry. Okay, you see that generally in the social media, people are angry. Why people are angry? Why people so angry? What caused people to become angry?
Last minute decision.
Yes, pardon me. Siapa tu? Who's that?
Last minute decision
of what? Okay, what I'm trying to say is COVID-19 is something, okay, there's no cure as at now. There's no vaccine, right? So all of us are afraid that we contracted the virus, correct? So there is a fear. Okay, there is a fear that we might contract it or we might catch the virus. Okay, now, when we fear something, okay, when we fear something, it may bring out the best of us or it may bring out the worst of us. Correct? When we fear something. But now, what happened, right? Because when we fear something, it causes to feel angry. Okay, we feel angry and we feel that we need to channel that what we feel, that we angry, we need to channel to someone. Correct? Our feeling to someone. So we always try to find someone, a scapegoat, so we can pour our angriness, what we feel to someone or to something, correct? So this is a stimuli that the feel that we feel, that we feel angry, is a response. Okay, it's a response to the stimuli that happened around us, meaning the external stimuli goes to our black box, which is our mind, then it created a response. So response here is in the form of feeling angry. Correct? So this is an example, okay, of this theory of behavioral learning. Okay, behavioral learning theory says that learning takes place as a result to the external event. Okay, so this is that theory. So, do you have any question? As at now, Muhammad Helmi, do you have any question, Muhammad Helmi?
No, sir.
All right, cool. All right. Now, okay, so next slide. And then go to the next slide, right? The question is, okay, the most important question is, as a marketer, how do you know the right stimuli to get the right response? Okay, how do you get the right stimuli to get the right response? For example, during fear of the COVID-19, when you speak to the people, are you going to make jokes? Is that going to get the right response from the people, for example? Okay, so that is, as a marketer, you must always think that how do you get the right stimuli to get the right response? Okay, so this is how you can use that theory, okay, the theory of behavior learning, okay, to your advantage. Meaning you know that based on this theory, people will respond based on the external event. So how do you use that in your marketing effort or your marketing campaign is to find the right stimuli to get the right response from your consumer. So this is something that you need to think whenever you embark or you started a marketing campaign. Okay, right. Now, next slide. Okay, next slide. We're talking about classical conditioning occurs when stimulus that elicits a response is paired with another stimulus that initially does not elicit a response on its own. Nah, apa ini? Okay, apa ini? Okay, conditioning. What's the meaning of conditioning? Dr. Ashraf, bila awak pakai conditioner?
Lama dah saya tak pakai.
Okay, conditioner selalunya apa? Shampoo, right?
Yes, sir. Shampoo.
You apply the shampoo, then after the shampoo, then you apply the conditioner. Kenapa kita pakai conditioner?
Tak nak bagi rambut rosak, dia just nak bagi lembut.
You condition your hair to behave in certain ways.
Ah, yes.
Correct? Sir. Meaning you that's why your hair like that. You know, you condition like that. What happen if you don't wear the conditioner?
My hair starts. Kind of in a bad shape, sir.
Bad shape. Okay. So the same thing when we learn about behavior, your behavior need to be conditioned to something. Okay, you need to condition your behavior, or you need to condition the behavior of the consumer to act in certain ways. Alright, so this is when you come with the classic conditioning. Okay. Classic conditioning occurs when stimulus that elicits a response, which elicits mean which invite a response, is paired with another stimulus that initially does not elicit a response on its own. Okay, what does it mean? Right, what does it mean? I'm not sure whether you have heard about Ivan Pavlov. Okay, Ivan Pavlov. Ivan Pavlov is a sociologist. Okay, sociologist. He did this experiment with his dog. Okay, so what he did was, okay, he will ring a bell. Okay, he will ring a bell, and after he rings the bell, then he will put in the meat powder to his dog mouth. Okay, and he do this every day. Every day. So every time he rings the bell, he put in the meat powder at the mouth of his dog. So he do this every day, right? Meaning to say, he try to condition the dog to act certain ways. So after a certain period, okay, after a certain period, every time he rings a bell, okay, every time he rings a bell, the dog, okay, the saliva will salivate. You can see the saliva going out from the dog's mouth without even putting the meat powder. So here is what we call classical conditioning. Okay, meaning you have a ring, you have the ring, and also you have the bell. then you also have the meat powder. Okay, you there's two stimulus here. So when the dog is been conditioned in certain period of time, okay, every time that Ivan Pavlov ring his bell, the dog will automatic, the saliva will go up from the dog's mouth. Automatic. This is condition. Okay, just like your hair. It's been conditioned. So it shows that our behavior can also be conditioned, just like your hair. Okay, so that is classical conditioning. Now, if you look at this next slide, it talks further about classic conditioning. Okay, there are two conditioning here: unconditional stimulus and conditional stimulus. Unconditional means conditioning which is without any syarat, without any prerequisite. It happened like that, without anything which influence. Conditional means something which is bersyarat. Something you need something to happen before something happen. Alright? Unconditional means without any terms, without any event to happen. You don't need something to happen before something else to occurs. Okay, for example, like before you can if you're thirsty, okay, you need to drink. Okay, that is conditional. Okay, unconditional means something which an event will occur without a prerequisite event to happen prior to that event. That is unconditional. Right. So, but however, unconditional and conditional stimulus would require repetition. Repetition is conditioning. You need to repeat that action again and again, again and again, like Ivan Pavlov dog. Okay, you need to do that again and again. All right, just like studying. Okay, you can't study one off and that's it. To build up the habit of studying, you need to repeat studying again and again and again and again. All right, so that's repetition and conditioning. So most of the time, these two stimulus come one after another. Remember Ivan Pavlov and the dog? He rings the bell first, then he put in the meat powder on the dog. Correct? So there are two stimulus here. It come one after another. Okay? And stimulus generalization refer to stimuli similar to conditional stimulus to evoke similar condition response. Okay, you can, this is something which Ivan Pavlov did to his dog. This generalization is what we call halo effect. Okay, halo effect. What is halo? Halo effect.
The ring of
charm. Normal.
Yeah.
Halo effect, okay. Halo, basically, you see gerhana bulan. You familiar with gerhana bulan?
Yes, sir.
Alright. What happened during gerhana bulan? You see that dark. During gerhana bulan, what do you see? You see a dark moon with light surrounding the dark moon, right? And that's halo. But in behavior, when we call halo effect, is our preconditioned perception about something. Preconditioned perception about something. For example, if I say the word proton, what is your preconditioned perception?
National car, sir.
Yeah. If national car, so national car is a title, but what is your perception, your feeling towards proton?
affordable car?
Affordable. How about quality?
Medium quality.
Medium quality. So you have like medium regard to Proton. But let's say Mercedes, for example. What's your first impression? Your perception?
Luxury.
Luxury. Rich people.
Good quality.
Rich people.
High quality.
Good quality.
Good quality. So that is halo effect. That is halo effect. Alright. It's the same when you look at other people. Okay, when you look at another people, you have that first impression of that people, of that person. Alright? That is halo effect. Okay, for example, you see someone with a skull cap and jubah, a robe. What is your first impression? He is a very religious person. Alright? If you see someone with a MacBook doing work in Starbucks, what is your perception?
Businessman, rich, busy.
And rich, busy. So that is your halo effect. Okay, so halo effect is your perception on something or someone. Okay, so that's a halo effect. Then you have cheap imitation goods. It will cause stimulus discrimination, whereby unconditional stimulus does not follow stimulus similar with conditional stimuli. What is stimulus discrimination? Right? For example, you know about Prada bag, for example. Okay, Prada bag. Then you know that in certain part of Malaysia, there are places where you can get what imitation Prada bag. And let's say, for example, in Hat Yai or Padang Besar, for example. Okay, Padang Besar. You know that you can easily get a cheap imitation bag. Correct? So, let's say you saw someone, a lady, wearing a Prada bag in Padang Besar. So what is your perception?
Fake.
Do you think that it must be fake, right? Your first impression that the bag must be fake. So that is stimulus discrimination. Because imitation goods, okay? It causes people to think that the product is fake. So it degraded, okay? The brand, the luxury brand just now, will be degraded. Right, that is stimulus discrimination. Any question? Ada soalan? Soalan? Tak ada?
So far no, sir.
Alright. So far no. Alright. Go to the next slide. Conditioning. Okay, conditioning just now. There are two types of conditioning. One is classical. We have learned this, classical. And another one is instrumental. Okay, conditional and instrumental. Classical, you have unconditioned, you have conditioned. Okay. And condition, we have learned about stimulus generalization. And we have learned about the halo effect. But the most important question that you need to ask yourself, what is the marketing effect to your product? How do you use this for your advantage? All right? And then you have stimulus discrimination. Stimulus discrimination, this one is can be divided into four, which is family branding. Family branding means for example, Campbell, the product Campbell. You have Campbell soup, you have soup cendawan, you have soup ayam, you know that That's what we call family branding. Then you have product line extension. What is product line extension? You learn this in other subject. What is product line extension?
Nur Ainul Hayat. Macam Tesco tu ke, sir?
Ah, kenapa dengan Tesco?
Tesco macam dia ada keluarkan macam-macam. Macam sabun sabun mandi, sabun basuh baju lah semua tu ke?
Ah, itulah dia. Product line extension. Sorry. Licensing? What is licensing? When you license someone to use your name. Right? You're so popular. Your brand is so popular. Like for example, like you're so popular. Like for example, Muhammad Helmi is so popular. So everyone wanted to be associated with Muhammad Helmi, for example. So let's say I wanted to come up with t-shirt. Muhammad Helmi t-shirt. So Muhammad Helmi said, okay, you can produce a t-shirt bearing the name Muhammad Helmi, but you need to pay a licensing fee. Okay, so that is licensing. And lastly, you have look-alike packaging. Look-alike packaging. Now, if you go to, for example, Guardian, for example, you go to the Guardian, mean to the drugstore, okay? You go to the Guardian. You look at the product Listerine. Listerine product. What is a Listerine? It's mouthwash, correct? Listerine. And you see that the bottle of Listerine is quite distinctive, correct? There's certain design for Listerine bottle. Anyone have not seen Listerine before? Semua dah pernah tengok ke?
Yes, sir. There are different changes between the sizes and this and the shape of the bottle differs in type of sizes. Yeah. The shape changes. Just this.
Okay, now if you look at the let's say Guardian, okay, Guardian also come out with their own mouthwash brand. Okay, they have their own mouthwash brand. But you look at the design of the bottle. Is it the same as Listerine? Is it the same or similar? May not be exactly the same, but similar. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is what we call look-alike packaging. Hey, you guys never go to Guardian, buy stuff, you know that? Never.
Pergi, sir, wajib.
Wajib?
Wajib setiap bulan.
Oh, wajib setiap bulan. Kenapa?
Beli macam-macam and selalu diorang ada promotion.
But, okay, next time, bulan ni dah pergi belum?
Dah pergi, baru je pergi.
Okay, next month awak pergi. Can you do me a favor?
Yes. Apa, sir? Boleh saya tolong?
Awak boleh tolong saya dengan awak pergi dekat tempat Listerine tu. Lepas tu awak perhati dia punya packaging. Dan awak bandingkan dengan packaging brand lain. Sama tak sama botol dia?
Okay. Boleh je.
Okay. Now, instrumental conditioning. Okay, you have positive reinforcement. Okay, meaning positive reinforcement means when you do something good, then people will say, good job. Okay, well done. That is positive reinforcement. Negative punishment means you get punished lah. When you do something wrong, then you get punished. Right? And then you may have a negative reinforcement. Okay, you is some sort like a punishment as well, but punishment is very severe. But negative reinforcement means when you do something bad, is a negative repercussion. Okay, may not be as severe as punishment, but for example, like if you do not brush your teeth, okay, you may lose your teeth, for example. Okay, you see that you see advertisement in the television. Okay, you say that what happened if you do not use this product? Okay, you may lose your teeth, for example, if you don't use this brand of toothpaste. So you may lose your first, you may have a bad breath, then you may lose your teeth. So that is what we call negative reinforcement. Okay, then instrumental also, you have an extinction. Okay, extinction of conditioning. Okay, you have fixed interval reinforcement, you have fixed ratio reinforcement, variable interval reinforcement, and variable ratio reinforcement. Okay, you go back and read these four things. What are the differences between all these four? Extinction, conditioning. Okay, right. Any question? No question? Okay, you go to the next slide. You go to the next slide. Amelia Sofia.
Yes, sir.
Where are you, Amelia Sofia?
Saya tak boleh buka. Ni, kalau tak nanti saya tak dengar what you say.
Tak boleh buka. Oh, ya ke? Okay. It's okay. As long as I can hear your voice. So, Amelia Sofia, give me an example of halo effect in marketing.
Okay, macam Apple. Dia keluarkan satu produk, everyone will say that dia punya product is good because of their previous product. Contohnya okay, macam lah. Contohnya macam dia keluarkan, first dia keluarkan Mac laptops kan. Lepas tu benda tu meningkat, apa tu, pembelian meningkat sebab before that produk dia yang lain semua have a good reputation.
Okay, that reputation is what? That reputation is what you mean by halo effect, is it?
Yeah.
So the reputation is the perception of the consumer towards Apple.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. Now, how Muhammad Amiluddin, how do you use that halo effect to your advantage?
To my advantage?
As a marketer.
Halo effect.
Halo effect.
As a marketer. For halo effect, for a first impression, I think I'll make sure when I meet my client, I wear the best suit that I have, perfumes, wash, to make sure that my client see me as a good marketer.
But that's when you try to do personal selling. But how do you use halo effect in branding?
Oh, in branding?
In positioning your product. How?
Okay, so I'll make sure that my product that coming out give good quality, to make sure that when I coming out with another product, people will trust it.
Mm-hmm. This is got something to do with brand positioning, yeah. Well, because when I talk last week, when we talk about brand positioning, we're talking about positioning the product or the brand in the mind of the consumer, correct? So whatever whenever a customer see a brand, okay, they have a certain perception. They have that halo effect. For example, like let's say Calvin Klein, for example. Okay, Calvin Klein come up with a perfume. Okay, come up with a perfume. So where do they present, or where do they position their brand into the mind of the consumer? Is it a cheap product, or is it a branded goods? Is it a premium product?
Premium product.
So that is the halo effect. Okay, this is how halo effect come into the picture. Meaning when you do your positioning, okay, when you do positioning of your product, this is how you use halo effect to your advantage. This is how you use the halo effect in your marketing campaign. When you try to position your product to the consumer. All right, you guys okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, cool. All right, go to the next slide. Next slide and another slide. Cognitive learning theory. Cognitive learning theory. Now, what is a cognitive learning theory? Okay, the importance of internal mental process, learning about products by observing others' behavior. Meaning to say, this is something like, okay, to simplify this, okay, to simplify this concept is by looking at brand ambassador, for example. Okay, and this is by observing the brand ambassador using the product, then you learn about the product. Okay, you learn to love about the product. So that is how some simplifying this concept. Okay, learning by way of observing, observational learning. Just now, you learn by experience. Okay, you learn by the external stimulus, but second way of learning is by observing. Okay, observing something being done. So you look at the next slide. Okay, first you give attention. Okay, the consumer need to give attention, focus on the model behavior. Meaning to say, you get the consumer to give the attention to your advertisement, right? And then you try to get the customer to retain this in their memory. Okay, retain this behavior in their mind. And then you must be able to get the consumer to perform that behavior. Okay, to perform that behavior. Then number four, you need to motivate. Okay, you motivate the consumer to perform that behavior. And lastly, get the consumer to observe, okay, that behavior. So this is what we call by observational learning. Okay, observational learning. So you may want to ask, so Sharin, how does this relevant to marketing? Okay, so this is where you get the advertisement which shows how are you going to use that product. Maybe it is a new product, it's a very complicated product. Educate the consumer on how to use the product. For example, when you have the new Proton X, what's the new Proton X? What? X50? 70? I'm not sure. X70. There's a lot of advertisement on how to use the car, on how to use the gadget in the car, how to use the the voice control, how to use the parking system of the car. So that is how it's educating the consumer by getting the consumer to observe on how the brand is or how the product is being used, and get the consumer to imitate or consumer to learn and do it themselves. Right? Why it is so important? Because if the consumer do not know how to use the product, then they will not motivated or they will not buy the product. Why? Because they do not know how to use the product. You must make sure that the consumer know how to use the product first, then they will be more inclined to buy the product. Okay, so that is observational learning process. Right, next slide. Cognitive learning principle. Again, okay, show the consumer what happened if you don't use, or what happened if you use the product. You use model. Okay, for example, you use in the advertisement, you show a consumer, if doesn't use the specific brand of toothpaste, then this is what going to happen to the teeth and to the social relationship with others and all that. So you show what is the consequences of using or not using the product. This goes beyond simple stimulus response connection. Okay, usually you use celebrity. Okay, someone who are well known to show how to use the product. Right. Any question? Question?
Not currently.
Not currently. And how do we learn to be consumers? Next slide. Okay, how do we learn to be consumers? You need to socialize, consumer socialization. Parents influence. Okay, parents influence. Sometimes we buy product or we learn about the product because of our parents. Okay, when you are young, okay, your parents will give you what? Milo lah, oatmeal lah. That's where you first encounter with the brand, correct? So next time, after you are big enough to buy your own drink, your own oatmeal, you buy certain brand or a brand which is you're familiar with, a brand which was introduced to you by your parents. Okay, that's parent influence. So parenting ni ada tiga jenis parenting lah. Dia ada authoritarian. Ni parent yang garang-garang tu is very authoritarian. Okay, semua kena dengar cakap parents. That's very authoritarian. There are neglecting parents. Maksudnya parents yang tak kisahlah kau nak buat apa pun. They allow you to do whatever you wanted to do. Neglect you. Or indulging parents. Parents who give you everything. Okay, for example, in China, because of the one child policy in China, every parents in China have only one child. So since they have only one child, they lavish their child with everything. Okay, these are what we call indulging parents. Okay, then secondly, you have television and the internet. This is how we learn about the product. This is how we learn about the brand, through the television and the internet. Then you have cognitive development. Then you have message comprehension. This is how all four ways of we learning to become consumers. Right. Then we learn about memories. Okay. After we learn, okay, at the first part of the lecture just now, we learn or we discuss about how we learn about something. Okay. Where, how we process that information. And this part of the lecture, okay, we're talking about the memories. How do you store that memories? Where do you store that memories? Okay, there are five types of memories. One is sensory memories, whereby this is memory about what you sense, about your what you this the smell, okay, the smell, the colors, what you see, what you hear. For example, if you go to the shopping mall, you smell cookies in shopping mall. Definitely, it reminds you of what? Famous Amos. Okay, it reminds you of Famous Amos. So this is what we call sensory memory. Certain smell reminds you of something. Okay, and then you have attention. Okay, attention is information that passes through an attention gate is transferred to short-term memory. Then you have short-term memory. Short-term memory is something is brief storage. Maksudnya, you remember about something, then after 5 minutes, you forget about that. Whatever you remember just 5 minutes ago. Whatever you feel, whatever you learn about 5 minutes ago, it's good, you forget about it because it you store in the short-term memory. Then you have elaborative rehearsal. Okay, elaborative rehearsal, whereby something which is transferred to your long-term memory. This is where the conditioning come into the picture. When you do something repetitively, you do something which is again and again, again and again, it becomes elaborative rehearsal. Alright? You do it every day. So when you do it every day, it will be stored in your long-term memory. Okay, long-term memory. This is that memory will be stored in your permanent hard disk in your brain. Okay, our brain is just like the computer. Our brain is just like a hard disk. It stores memory. Your computer stores data the same as our brain. Okay, so our brain is like a natural computer. Okay, it stores data, it processes data the same as computer. Okay, now how our memory store information. Okay, one is by associating something with something. Okay, associating something with something. This is like halo effect, perception. You associating a brand with something else. Mercedes with luxury, Mercedes with quality. Okay, Givenchy with luxury. Alright, Hanyai with what? Fake goods, for example. So you associating something with something. Ini ialah neuron-neuron ataupun your neuron otak tu berhubung. Awak lihat iklan susu kan? Ganglosida, DHA and all that. Menyebabkan neuron-neuron anda berhubung. You have this brand recall. Okay, how do you get the brand to, how do you get people to recall about your brand? Okay, this, you have brand specific, advertisement specific, brand identification, product category and evaluative reaction. Alright, and then you go to the next slide. This is the most important thing when you as a marketer need to understand. How do we retrieve memories when we decide what to buy? Meaning, you have given your advertisement, you have shown your advertisement to the consumer. The consumer had processed the information about your advertisement. Then it will store the information about your product or brand in their brain. But now you wanted to retrieve that information. You wanted the customer to recall about your brand. You wanted the customer to recall about your product. Why? Because you wanted the customer to go and buy your product. Okay, so every time the customer wanted to buy the product, a certain product, you wanted them to recall about your brand. Okay, so that is why we need to get the consumer to retrieve their memories when they decided to buy. Now, individual cognitive or physiological factors are some of the differences in retrieval ability among people. So meaning to say, some people need to remember about the brand product. Sudoku, for example. Okay, Sudoku, for example, is a mental gymnastic, meaning it exercise your mind. Okay, you exercise your mind to remember about something. But as you get older, you become forgetful. Correct? As you become older, you become forgetful. But there is one condition that quite interesting. I assume most of you still have your grandparents. Guys, yeah, Nur Ainul, Hayat, your grandparents still alive? Nur Ainul, Hayat? Yes, okay. Okay, if you sit down with your grandparents, what do they normally do? They will tell you about what? What story? When they are young, correct? When you sit with your grandparents, they will tell you about their younger days. When they are young, they do this, correct? Am I right? No, I know yet. Tak. So what your grandparents talk about what?
Politics.
Oh. Okay. All right. There are some grandparents talking about politics. But okay, now. Politics is one of the topics. But let's say you sit down long enough with your grandparents, okay? Most of the time they will talk about their younger days, okay? But when they are young, they do this. When they're young, they do that. You know that they can still remember what they did, okay? 20 to 30 years ago. But they can't remember whether they have taken medicine 5 minutes ago. You ask them, Atuk dah makan ubat? Lupa. Dah kot. No? Whatever they did 5 minutes ago, they tend to forget. But they can remember what they did 20 or 30 years ago. Right? Why? It's quite fascinating, right? How the brains work. You can remember what you did 30 years ago, but you can't remember what you did last 5 minutes. For the past 5 minutes, you can't remember. Just like this this lesson. We just have this lesson for like 1 hour and 33 minutes. If I ask you, what is the in the first slide, you can't tell me. But if I ask you, what do you do, what do you did when you are 10 years old, then you can give me the answer. Why? It's quite fascinating, right? So this is something that a marketer try to remind or try to do to the consumer. Do you see that sometimes marketer or advertiser, when they advertise in the television, they brings back the memories. For example, they goes back retro. Okay, they goes retro. Okay, in their advertisement. Why? Okay, this is what we have learned last week. Okay, to bring back the memories of the good old days. Okay, because we still remember what we did when we are still young. Okay, this is something that a marketer always manipulate. They try to manipulate our memories because they know that as human, we can remember what we did 30 years ago. So they try to remind us that good old days. Okay, for example, for those who are in their 40s or 50s, retros, meaning the 70s is their golden era. Okay, so when the marketer remind them of the 70s, the retro era, then somehow it excites this group of people of 40s to 50s. Okay, all right. So, but then sometimes it's also young. Why? Because when you see something new, you always see the current. But when you see something old, but given a new breath, then you see something fresh. For example, like this song. Okay, this song is quite old by Frank Sinatra. Fly Me to the Moon. Okay, I have not heard about this song for quite some time. Fly Me to the Moon by Frank Sinatra. But yet, I think it become popular like 2 or 3 months ago through TikTok. Alright, this song become popular again. Okay, Frank Sinatra, Fly Me to the Moon is, Frank Sinatra is in the 50s. But it become popular in 2020. Alright, this is something as a marketer you need to utilize this, okay, as a marketer. There's another song. I forgot the name of the song. Can you guys like remind me? I become old already. Mental Decay. An old song but given a new fresh tune by this woman singer. Apart from Fly Me to the Moon, another song in TikTok. Can you guys help me on this? What was the name of the song?
Nyanyi sikit, sir.
Korang tak ada TikTok ke?
Tak ada.
Tak main. Ashraf ada. Nur Ashraf ada.
Yelah.
I think Muhammad Aminuddin dia ada TikTok. Betul tak Muhammad Aminuddin?
Tak ada, sir.
Muhammad Aminuddin?
Ya, tak ada, sir. Sedengar tak?
Pak Aminuddin.
Cuba nyanyi dia. Ya.
Okey, siapa kat
sini yang ada TikTok? Sir, sedengar tak? Hello?
Guys, soalan.
Ya, yes, sir.
Semua ada TikTok? Okey. Cool. Alright, so saya you know what song that I'm talking about, right? Now, how do we remind? Okay, how do we remind the consumer about our brands? Okay, one, you have pictorial. Okay, pictorial versus, it should be verbal cues. Okay, pictorial versus verbal cues. We love picture compared to words. That's normal. Okay. State dependent retrieval. Familiarity and recall. Right? Varying contexts. Okay, salience and recall. This is how we remind consumer about something. So this is the same way of you reminding your consumer about your brand. Okay. The most effective way is by picture, pictorial. That's why now you have all this infographic. You see, last time, okay, when the government wanted to show about their policies, they just give a statement. But now in social media, you see that when the government wanted to explain about their policies, they always put in picture. Okay, always put in a picture in a what do you call infographic. Just like this slide. Okay, I can put in the slide all verbal, all in writing. I put a paragraph in the slide. But I mix and match. I put in pictures, I put in diagram, right? Why? It try to elicit recall. It's easy to recall something. Okay? Because we think in our mind, when we remember something, we remember through pictures. All right? For example, like, let's say I wanted to recall Nur Farida Hanim, for example. Okay, in my mind, the word Nur Farida Hanim doesn't come to my mind. But what comes to my mind is the face of Nur Farida Hanim. Correct? So this is how you recall something. You recall something in picture form, not in not in what you call in written form. Correct? For example, let's say KLCC. Are you in your mind, is it the word KLCC or you saw the building in your mind?
Building.
The building, sir.
I mean, not I.
The building.
I mean, not I. You are in mute.
Hello?
Aini? Nur Ain?
Yes, hello. Tak dengar ke si?
I can't hear you.
Saya dah unmute.
Aini, you are on mute. You need to...
Hello?
Okay.
Hello, Aini. I dengar you.
So what do you see? Okay. Is the... When I talk about KLCC, do you see the word KLCC or you see the building?
I see the building.
Saya tak dengar tu.
Yeah. Hello. Sir. Kau dengar tak?
Aini. Sir.
Dengar. Diorang dengar tapi saya tak dengar.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Siapa tak dengar I tadi?
James.
Yeah. I think something wrong with your mic. Alright. So, right. Your mic. Right. Maybe. Now, let's go to the discussion. Okay, discussion. Discussion. Muhammad Helmi. Discussion. Advertisers like to use celebrities and well-known faces to help promote their products and brand or service. Do you think it's a good idea?
Sorry, sir.
Muhammad Helmi.
Yeah.
Advertisers like to use celebrities and well-known faces to help promote their products. Do you think it's a good idea?
Yeah, I think it's a good idea because they can give what influence to other people.
Oh, all right. What kind of influence?
I mean, they are famous, right? Then they if someone saw, for example, if they use some brand, then other people will follow them too.
Okay. How about if the celebrities gone into trouble?
Hmm?
For example, like if the celebrities, they got into a controversy, for example.
But there's still some people who support them, right? Even though...
So there's some... it may have some effect, but you say that it is something which can be mitigated.
Yeah.
Okay. So, second one. I mean or Ain, sorry about just now. I think the connection between the laptop and my headphone disconnect.
Never mind, sir. I'm okay. All good.
Yeah. So second one, what is the major differences between behavioral and cognitive theories of learning? What's the difference between behavior and cognitive learning? What's cognitive? What is cognitive?
Internal mental processor? Betul.
Right, all right. Cognitive is that behavior.
Focus on someone's behavior on external. On external. Focus on external.
Okay, cognitive just now, when we talk about the black box, your mind is just like a black box, right? Whereby your mind is stimulated by the external simulation or stimulation, all right? Then it elicits response. Okay, it causes response based on that stimulation. That is cognitive, because cognitive, when you heard the word cognitive, you instantly know that cognitive means what it has got something to do with your mind. Cognitive is what's going on in your mind. That's cognitive. Behavioral learning means when you look at, you learn from observing others doing it. Okay, for example, like how to learn to use this headphone, for example. This headphone there's some problem to connect this headphone to the MacBook, for example. So to learn on how to solve the problem, I may use cognitive learning whereby I can read the manual. Okay, I can read the manual. Or it can be by way of behavioral learning. If I switch on the YouTube and I look at the video on how people how they demonstrate on how to solve the problem. So that is behavior learning. So by observing. Okay, so this is two way of learning. All right, so number three, Muhammad Johan Alif.
Yes, sir.
How can marketers use sensory memory to our advantage?
Marketers use sensory,
what is sensory memory?
Sensory memory. Their thoughts, maybe.
What is senses? Your five senses. What are they? Your five senses.
Deria.
Dalam bahasa Melayu ni deria. Dari penglihatan, dari rasa, dari apa lagi? Sound, dengar, right? Yang awak hidup. So now, how marketers use the sensory memory to their advantage? Okay, now, you go to, all of you have been to a normal Malay warung, kopi.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Have any one of you been to Starbucks cafe?
Yes, sir.
Not regularly, sir.
Not regular, but you've been there, right? Can you tell me the difference?
Yes.
The price, the quality,
when you put a normal one. And what does your senses tell you when you go to Starbucks?
The scent, the sense of coffee.
Sense of coffee, smell something.
Jazz music.
That's what you hear. You go to normal warung, what do you hear?
Dandut.
Dandut. Okay, that is how marketers use sensory memory to their advantage. Okay, meaning if you go to Starbucks, your five senses give you something. Means you smell coffee, you hear jazz music or modern music. What do you see? what do you see? The interior design, the design of that cafe is different. All right, but then if you go to the normal warung, you what do you smell? Maybe the smoke from the nearby exhaust, car exhaust nearby. Alright, yang lalu lalang depan warung tu. You hear orang horn kereta sebab dekat tepi jalan. What else? What do you see?
Bau goreng-goreng.
Bau goreng-goreng. That is what you smell also. So it's different senses, correct?
Yes, sir.
So you equate certain senses and equate certain sensory memory to certain brand. So Starbucks had managed to use these five senses. Means when you go to Starbucks, they utilize the sensory memory for their advantage. Alright? Last question. Last question. How many? Okay, the one who give me the quickest, the answer quickly, the quickest, get something from me. How many turtle picture are there in the lecture today?
One.
Four.
Four. One.
Dua.
Dua.
Dua, sir.
Dua. Dua ke tiga?
Dua je.
Dua je. Ya, jelas korang.
Scroll banyak sangat kan jadi empat.
Korang dah selak-selak tadi kan, dah nampak lah jawapannya. Kau ingat saja-saja aku letak gambar turtle kat dalam slide tu?
Tak, tak saja-saja.
Saya tak rasa saja sebab tiba-tiba je ada turtle kat situ.
Kreativiti.
Sengaja, sir.
Sebab when we talk about long term memory, short term memory just now, right? So I just wanted to illustrate to you, okay? How, what is our attention span? How long are we going to store that memory in our mind? Okay. Sometimes when you talk, it's either one or four or three. You're not certain, right? Why? Because why does that happen? You're not sure whether it's one, three, or four. One, two, three, or four. Why? You're not certain. Why? What's the reason?
Not focus.
The attention. Alright. Sometimes we can recall something because we give the attention to something. It's the same as advertisement. Remember when I talk about advertisement is like an interruption. It is an interruption to our daily life. It interrupts us for our attention. So if there is so many advertisement in the social media, we cannot focus. We cannot give attention, correct? So when we cannot give attention, how can we recall that advertisement? So this is what I'm trying to illustrate. Okay. So when you give, or you come up with an advertisement, okay, for your product or for your service or for your ideas, how do you get that attention from your consumer? Why attention is so important? Because it will increase what? The brand recall. Because just now you already gave me the answer. If you don't give the attention, you can't recall how many turtles are there in the slides presentation. Correct? So that is why this is why you need to give attention. This is why you need to get the attention from the consumer. So that sum up what I'm trying to say in the whole lecture today. Okay, when we talk about memories, when we talk about how people learn about something, and after they learn about something, how do they store that memory in their mind? Okay, it has something to do with brand recall. Okay, because when people can't recall your brand, when they wanted to buy something, then they can't recall your brand. Then it's very dangerous for you. Why? Because they will not buy your brand. They will buy something else. Okay, you already lost there. Okay, they look at your brand, say, I can't remember this one. This must be something new. It's not something familiar.
So, sir.
Yes.
Kan biasa setiap produk dia akan ada duta ambassador dia kan? Uh-huh. Untuk bagi orang ingat siapa duta pegang produk dia. Biasanya right. Memang ada seorang saja. Tapi kenapa macam Oppo, dia banyak sangat ambassador dia. Penyanyi-penyanyi ramai sangat. Lepas tu setiap kali dia launch, boleh cakap ada duta yang baru. Why dia buat macam tu?
Interesting question. I don't know the answer. Okay, right. I can only assume. Alright. It must be a brand strategy. Why? Because one, they wanted to show that so many people are
using it.
Using it. Meaning, this is what we call herd mentalities. Okay, herd mentality. When people, a lot of people using that brand, then you use the product. Just like now, when everybody is bashing the government for not doing the MCO, you also follow that one. Why? Because when you say that a lot of people saying the same thing, then it must be true. The same thing is product. When a lot of people is using the same product, then the product must be good. Alright, secondly, it may be because of the segmentation. Okay, maybe because of the segmentation, because you look at the ambassador. Okay, look ambassador. You look at those who follow that ambassador. Okay, I think Oppo, most probably they having what? Korean artists, something like that?
Yes, one Korean male artist.
Indonesia is Neelofa.
Oppo. Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So you look at, they try to catch the follower of that. You try to catch that follower of that artist. But it's very dangerous. You need to remind, okay, let's say you have brand, right? You get an artist to use your brand. It's quite dangerous, you know. You must make sure that the artist in their social media use your brand. Because you have those Neelofa, Siti Nohariza, who are the brand ambassador for Oppo. But in the social media, people can see that using iPhone.
Yes, correct.
So it may, you know, it may serve as a double-edged sword. Means it may go against you. So when you get the celebrity to endorse your brand, make sure they are die with your brand. Okay. Seen with your brand, not only through advertisement but during last time. Ada soalan tak?
Tak ada, sir.
Tak ada.
Soalan am tu macam ni, sir?
Soalan am?
Bertukar-tukar.
Assume.
Ini macam pengajian am ke apa?
Kan, sir. Amiluddin, sir.
Oh, Amiluddin.
Kan dia tanya tadi yang apa ambassador bertukar-tukar tu.
Ah, yelah, kan saya dah jawab. Satu sebab alhamdulillah.
Amin.
Aduh.
Saya confused.
Tak fokus.
Ni tak fokus. Aku pun tak fokus.
Belaga ni.
Alah dia bertukar-tukar ambassador, right? Jawapannya ialah satu. Okay, about herd mentalities. Because you wanted to show that so many people are using the brand. Okay, kalau ada ramai ambassador yang guna brand tu, as if macam dia kata ramai yang menggunakan brand ni. Jawapan keduanya ialah segmentation. Alright, because you wanted to catch or you wanted to get the follower of that celebrity to buy your brand. For example, kalau macam Oppo tadi kan, you have katalah Neelofa. Neelofa jadi brand ambassador. So nanti semua pengikut Neelofa tu akan beli Oppo juga. Then you have Siti Nohariza using endorsing Oppo. So semua ni peminat-peminat Siti Nohariza pun ikut beli Oppo. So it's market segmentation. Alright, So first answer is about that herd mentalities. Secondly, is about market segmentation.
Okay, dapat. Sorry, saya confused sikit.
Dapat ke Muhammad Amin?
Dapat, dapat. Saya. Dapat, dapat.
Sila bagi attention. Learning process. Alright. Now, next week. Okay, next week we going to the same thing. Before we go for the third lecture, okay, next topic, next week, we going to do the case study for S model, okay, the second case study. Please, okay, please read the case study before you come to class, alright? You don't need to get the full answer, but sufficient answer for you to discuss. Okay, first, you need to understand about the case study. Okay, understand the flow, understand what is the case study is trying to say, the crux of the case study. Then, secondly, the question preceding the case study. Alright. And next week also, you need to submit the first part of your group assignment, which carries 20% of your marks of your group assignment. My question is, do you? Any one of you do not have any group right now? Dia seorang-seorang.
Saya belum.
Siapa tu?
Saya Farida Hanim.
Okay, saya Farida Hanim. Siapa nak ambil awak? Try to market yourself sekarang.
Siapa yang ada kosong lah.
I wanted to resolve now. Why? Because previous semester I got situation whereby dah nak exam baru bagi tahu tak ada group. Dah nak present baru bagi tahu tak ada group. Lepas tu nak buat seorang-seorang, memang tak lah. Right? Group assignment is a group lah. Mana seorang-seorang? So, can anyone adopt Nur Farida Hanim?
Me, sir.
Siapa tu?
Siti Nur Syakira.
Siti Nur Syakira. Okay. Adoptlah Siti, adoptlah Nur Farida Hanim ni. Kesian. Okay, anyone else? Okay,
sir. Sir, saya Sir Hafizul Hazwan.
Hafizul Hazwan. Siapa nak ambil dia pula? Siapa ada kekosongan lagi? Ataupun kesian tengok. Hafizul Hazwan, tolong apa cerahkan sikit awak punya kamera tu. Awak tak nampak muka awak.
Tak nampak eh. Sini gelap, Sir.
Itulah. That's marketing lah. Awak gelap-gelap mana awak nak nampak?
Ya, ya, buka flash. Saya buka flash.
Sila tunjulkan diri anda.
Mana tempat?
Lampu handphone tu pun boleh.
Yap, sir. Ambil lighting.
Touch up sikit,
eh.
Siapa? Okey, siapa nak ambil Hafizul Hazwan ni? Semua, okey, sekarang ni korang ada buat, dalam grup korang ada berapa? Siapa yang ada masih tiga? Kalau ada tiga, boleh ambil Hafizul Hazwan. Muka Hafizul Hazwan dah ada. Siapa nak ambil dia dalam grup dia? Cepat. Sorry to say Hafizul Hazwan, awak tak popular. Semua tak nak awak.
Dia tersingkir ke apa, sir?
Tak, ini bukan Akademi Fantasia lah. Awak tersingkir dari subjek. Awak tak diterima dalam tribe masalahnya. Adakah awak selalu membuat orang marah?
Tak, saya budak semester baru.
Budak, saya tak kena. Alright, okay guys, tolonglah dia, budak semester baru. Siapa yang boleh memimpin dia ke jalan yang lurus? Cepat.
So, saya tahu ni semua sini-sini ni.
Eh, korang gelak-gelak, korang tak nak ambil ke? Setakat gelak tak boleh membantu dia ni.
Saya panggil Hanim, Hanim.
Siapa? Farida Hanim?
Ah, ya. Yeah. Farida Hanim.
Farida Hanim, awak pun sendiri, awak sendiri pun diadopt oleh orang lain, awak nak adopt dia orang lain pula. Macam mana? Awak Siti Nur Syakirah yang adopt awak. Awak kena tanya Siti Nur Syakirah dia nak
tak. Grup dah ada 4 orang cukup.
Ah, dah. Awak ni baru masuk grup orang dah mandai-mandai.
Oh, ya. Yeah. Okey, tak pasal.
Nol Ainul Hayat, boleh tolong tak? Boleh?
Dah penuh rasa.
Penuh? Cukup saya. Okay, aku tak tahu korang settle this problem. It's 2 o'clock. Okay, wait, I need to solve this now. Minggu depan korang kena hantar dah a portion of your report. Cepat. Siapa lagi ni? Siapa yang tak penuh lagi? Siapa yang ada 3, 4? Okay, kalau 4, I would allow for 5. Exception.
So, kan ada 16 orang je dekat dalam ni. So, mestilah satu grup 4 orang je.
Oh, iya ke? Okay, now maksudnya ada grup yang masih lagi 3 orang.
Confession.
Come on guys.
Tanya sorang-sorang sir.
Please dalam group sir.
Tak payahlah aku tanya sorang-sorang. Korang you yourself know how many people are there in your group. Berapa aku nak tanya sorang-sorang? This is the downside of democracy. When I give you freedom to choose, you are spoiled of choice. Nur Ashraf bin Nur Azlan.
Yes, sir.
Awak dah berapa orang dah?
Saya dah full, sir. Saya dengan Nur Ainul Hayat, sir.
Okay. Okay, there must be some group yang masih lagi 3 orang, right? Nur Ainul Hayat, grup saya Izzat Azim Nur Ashraf Handsome. I do not know, dalam list tak ada Nur Izzat Handsome ni.
Allahu.
That is perception. Okay, halo effect. Okay, not yet proven.
Apa, not yet.
Mengaruh okay, Pasti lagi 3 orang, come on guys, tolong. Can I leave you guys on this? You guys go and talk among yourself. Can I do not want to impose. Okay, it must be on voluntary basis. But I need to make sure that everyone have their own group. Okay, saya tak nak ada yang anyone left behind. Can you take this up? Dekat dalam WhatsApp group, bincang dalam WhatsApp group. Can I trust you guys to do that?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Alright, cool. Okay, sir. And next week, I would expect you to submit the first portion of your group assignment, yeah? Which carries your 20 marks. Why? Because I need to look at your reports and see how can you go further for your how should you proceed further for your next stage of your group assignment. Okay.
Sir.
Yeah.
Yang group assignment tu yang mana? Satu kan saya ada bagi 2 attachment tu kan?
Yes.
Yang kan due date dia kan sebagi sampai Januari tu kan? So yang mana satu yang nak kena submit by next week?
Yang Okay, let's look at your VLE. Okay, under assignment, you have in a group assignment, correct?
Group yes. Assignment.
All right. There are two attachments, correct? From sweetheart to scapegoat. Satu.
Yang tu lah nak kena hantar.
Yang itu is the article.
All right.
Article tu tentang awak taking brand selfie. Okay, from sweetheart to scapegoat, brand selfie taking shapes, consumer behavior. Correct? That's the article. Kan? So, you need to read the article. Baca, 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 baca. Sampai habis. Then you understand what is the article is all about. Then awak tutup. Okay? Awak tutup. Then you look at the second attachment. Whereby it says group assignment. Okay? And then dia ada... what they call this summary of that article, then there the instruction, betul?
Betul.
Okay, instruction step one, read the full paper for better idea of this topic. Maksudnya awak kena baca artikel tadilah. Step two, okay, step two, you need to come up with a write-up of your intended outline topic. Okay, it should clearly outline the question that you hope to answer. Number dua, how you might think about testing how brand selfie shapes consumer behavior. And number three, what implication you think it might have. Tell us why you care about it and why you think it should be studied. Okay, this due date on week 3, 20 marks. Okay, 20 marks. Maksudnya minggu depan lah. Okay, awak bagi saya outline yang 1, 2, 3 ni tadi. Okay, and then instruction nombor 2. The week 13 class session will be dedicated to student presentation. Okay, and then presentation will be 8 to 10 minutes long, including discussion, and will include one, an overview of your idea or question. Number two, how it affects consumer behavior. Three, how this question might be informed by other. Three, the result of your experiment. And five, what the implication to marketers might be. Okay. Right. So, yang minggu depan tu, what you need to write, okay, ialah how are you going to approach this question? Okay, maksudnya, kalau you wanted to, you read the article about brand selfie shaping consumer behavior, alright, minggu depan you need to tell me how are you going to test this question. Betul ke brand selfie ni shaping consumer behavior? If betul, how do you test? So minggu depan ni is more like your proposal of your research. And then week 13 is your final report. Mean after you propose that you wanted to, for example, let's say you propose that you wanted to scroll through all your followers in Instagram. Nak tengok berapa ramai your friend from January to October yang ambil gambar dengan brand. For example, dia ambil gambar dengan Evian bottle, for example. Okay. Berapa ramai yang buat? Berapa kekerapan dia? How many the duration? You know that. Awak nak test macam tu pun boleh. Ataupun awak nampak ada satu seorang kawan awak ni selalu ambil gambar dengan Mary Kay, for example. Dia hari ni ambil gambar dengan gincu Mary Kay, besok dia ambil gambar dengan perfume Mary Kay. Lepas tu awak nak buat soalan kat dia, awak nak tanya interview dia. kenapa buat macam ni, berapa kerap buat macam ni. So you also can do that. So tomorrow, next week is about your proposal on how are you going to test this this issue on brand selfie. Minggu ke-13 is the report of your experiment, of your test. Okay tak? Faham ke ni?
Faham, sir.
Alright. So faham, sir.
Faham, sir.
Okay, dah siap ke? Dah buat ke ni? Dah start ke buat?
Belum.
Belum.
Dah ada niat tu.
Apa dia?
Niat dah ada.
Niat dah ada. Attention. Alright. So I leave you guys now. Alright. First you need to solve the problem of this Hafizul Hazwan. Okay, get sir. Him. Yes.
Tak apa sir, dah settle.
Dah settle. Alhamdulillah. Dah, dah. So next okay, week
thank I will you. Expect thank you very much sir.
Okay, so anyone else yang tak ada group? Tak ada. Okay. So next week hantar the first portion. Okay. Send through VLE. Ya. Yeah? Send through VLE.
Sir, nak tanya satu guys. Pasal brand test, brand safety testing tu more to marketing methods nak kita nak gunakan macam mana ni, sir?
No, the issue in the article, the article says that brand selfie will shape the consumer behavior towards the brand.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. But you wanted to test, betul ke? Is it true?
Macam nak clarify lah benda tu.
Yeah, betul. How do you clarify? How do you test that hypothesis that when you take brand selfie with a brand, it will shape your behavior, your response, your attitude towards the brand. Is it correct? Or is it one time? Or is it something which is you have nothing, although you take a selfie with the brand, but you have no you're not connected emotionally with the brand. Is it true? Okay, so the report that I would expect next week is your approach in testing that hypothesis.
Alright, sir.
Alright. But there's no true or false. Okay, you can use any method. Okay, the report next week is only for me to see. And I will further discuss when I look into your report, then I will further discuss with you on your method, on your experiment, you know that, your intended method, you know that. Okay, so there's no right or wrong answer for your first report. Okay, it's just your proposal. It's just that I wanted to see your proposal. That's all. Alright. Okay. Any other question? Ada soalan lain? Tak ada?
No, sir.
Alright. So, I'll see you next week. Don't...